Bound Spartan in the top lane, Intendude X in the jungle, Shifter in mid lane, Wizfusion on AD, and Daydreamin' on support.
All right, Curtis definitely has their work cut out for him in this picks ban phase, because Zion Spartan has showed great on Jax and great on Lee Sin, which also poses a problem, right? Mm. Because now you're going to get direct bans. So yeah. Try going mediocre on one of those champions.
Yeah. Try just, you know, not playing all the crazy stuff that might get targeted banned out. If it does happen, though, it could give them a lot of power picks coming through the other side. Yeah. I don't know if we'll see a repeat performance of Lee Sin two games in a row. He has been a type of person who just picks one champion and two right. stops being successful on it. But he really has a diverse champion pool in that top lane. It's just a deep sheet of different champions he's played.
Both of these teams have lanes that have up to 9 and 7 champions played differently in those lanes. This team definitely has big champion pools.
Like you were saying, Jax ban, of course. I really do like watching these Coast games, though, because the top lane matchup is usually so unique, especially against a guy like Kwas. I can't wait to see. You know, I'll be very disappointed if these guys play Mundo versus Shyvana against each other, because they both have so much ability to play outside the box things. Seeing Gragas, Zac, and Karthus from Kwas, and just a plethora of picks from Zion Spartan. Lee Sin, Jax, Riven, Yasuo, and also like a carry Nasus when he played that.
Curse comes into this game 5-10. Coast is 6-9. To make it 7-9 or 6-10 for these guys. Nobody wants to get that lost here at the end of the week. We're going into a super week. These guys want to be riding high. Elise gets banned out on the side for Coast. Curtis will not get their hands on that. I'm sure a Pantheon's going to have to be somewhere. Maybe I'm not sure. Who knows? Yeah. Annie's still
it
up.
It could definitely
lots
fall through. Because there were so many targeted bans.
Ooh, finally.
Finally that Lulu ban we were expecting. Because there were so many targeted bans by Curse.
Right.
A lot of the stuff that is traditionally banned is right up on the table. Now it's just a priority for Curse. How much do they care about I Will Dominate's Pantheon? And do they want to pick it immediately?
Been banned against him 11 times. So for it to be left up, I know Dominate. He is getting giddy right now.
Yeah, there's another thing they could do, a Thresh right off the bat.
St. Vicious's favorite support.
Caitlyn has been picked 6 times. By Cop is most played. That would be a contested pick between the two because Fusion has played it 5 times on the Coast side. A lot of stuff here, and whatever Curse doesn't take, they're kind of giving right back to Coast. Because the bans were so targeted, it's almost an advantage, I feel like, for Coast to be second pick because they get 2 of the 3 that have been left up, really. They could get Thresh and Caitlyn here if they wanted it.
Zion Spartan hovers the Riven. He has had a chance on that. In week 2, it was a loss, but I believe that's just a hover, playing on the minds of Curse until they lock in what they really want. Intendude probably locking his jungler on this one. They don't have to since they see Pantheon, though.
Well, they can do whatever. I think it's mainly their power picks. You just go and look at their most played champions that haven't been banned yet. Thresh, I think, just because of his overall versatility, and also because it fits in really well with the style Coast has been playing lately. The Lucian makes sense, too, over the Caitlyn because he is more elusive in the long run. It's this weird thing the Coast has been doing. They've basically been letting Shifter and Zion almost 2v5, in a sense, where the other three are just this roaming threat that is just trying to stay alive. You often see Wizfusion build a Blade of the Ruined King as his first item on AD carry because it just gives him more mobility, and he doesn't necessarily care about his full teamfight power. It's a really interesting strategy that has been working out for Coast.
Gragas being locked in here. That's going to be going to Void Boy mid lane, possibly. That could be going to Kwas. Void Boy locks in the Annie, though. St. Vicious more than happy to grab that up as support.
If you're playing against Curse, it's Gragas any lane. You have no idea where he's going to be going. Could even be a jungler for I Will Dominate. He's picked it once. Void Boy actually hasn't even played it.
No, he hasn't.
Curse has picked Gragas twice. It hasn't went mid lane once.
See if they can turn the tide on this game. Shifter and Wiz Fusion to lock in some votes, or lock in some champions, I should say. Now, the votes are coming. Let's see who you guys voted on.
Yeah, I wonder what Shifter's going to do without Nidalee. That's really how they found the majority of their success. You know, Coast has won 6 games. 4 of them have been with Nidalee. Mm-hmm. They're going to end up waiting for the very last pick.
As usual.
I worry a little bit that Coast has went too conventional with those 2 last picks. The Shyvana and Vi pretty much have to go straight in together. And in team fight heavy compositions, Coast has not found much success. Remember those 3 games where they played Wukong and Katarina?
Right.
They were not successful playing that strategy, and they might be pigeonholing themselves into that with the Vi and Shyvana picks.
last pickup here is going to be for Shifter.
Mid lane blitz. Not gonna happen.
See what he can lock in. Shifter always takes a power play champion, or whatever he takes turns into a power play champion. I think everybody remembers the Ahri.
Yep.
We're gonna have that locked in again for him.
Solid pick right there. Most likely going against the Gragas. He played that matchup against Bjergsen and really ruined Bjergsen's day. And that amazing upset win Coast had over TSM. However, I'm disappointed we get to see the two most versatile top laners in North America play Renekton against Shyvana. They would go and do that. Such a pivotal game.
We're actually seeing the top lane be somewhat of an island. We can expect to see that again. So Dominate does get his Pantheon and Tendudex onto Vi. We actually saw he on Vi was a pivotal part of shutting down Dyrus in the top lane versus Team Solomid with Zion Spartan.
Yeah, very important ganks when he was trying to get Zion Spartan going. And just these team comps in general aren't really fitting of the team's overall strategies when they found success. Coast has a very strong team fighting composition with Divine and Shyvana comboing in with each other, whereas Curse, since they brought the Pantheon with the Gragas, are very pick-oriented and might look to find those skirmishes. So this could be a game. Anything's up for grabs, really, because the teams are both playing different strategies.
Well, these guys have been chomping at the bit. We are into our final LCS game of the day. And as the teams load onto the Rift, let's tally the votes at lolesports.com. Our closest one of the day at 51% of you thinking that Curse is going to come out on top.
That's about right.
Might with be the closest way these teams have been going. Ever.
Yeah, that's an incredibly close vote. Good job. 5-10 record for Curse, 6-9 record for Coast overall. The champion select actually going in very curious directions. I feel like with the bans by Curse, they did a good job of kind of forcing Coast onto things that they hadn't been dominating with. Getting the Jax out of the way, and specifically the Nidalee, I think, really messes with the way Shifter's playing.
It's going to be a great lane matchup for each one of these lanes. Quaz obviously going to push Zion Spartan in. We said that Shifter was pretty aggressive and got the advantage over Bjergsen in mid on that Gragas. So we'll see how Voidboy takes to it. He's really somebody we are watching. His Syndra play, like we said, it was a game loss, but he played quite well on that Syndra and still did some things for his team that could have gotten them back in. Cop on Caitlyn. He's been having a great time, like we said. Six plays on that Caitlyn.
Yeah. He only 2-4 on it, but that's going to happen when your team is seventh place in the standings overall.
Right.
I'm a little interested in the bottom lane as well because we're going to be so focused on the mid lane matchup, but basically just how WizFusion and Daydream deal with Cop. Cop has actually been out farming and being a bit of a lane bully to most people in the LCS, kind of the unsung hero of Curse when we pay so much attention to the craziness of Voidboy. Cop has been steadily consistent like always, but ever improving. And I want to see if he can shut down WizFusion and Daydream here.
Ever improving with a revolving door on that support position.
Yeah. I mean, think about how many supports he's had to play with. It was Elements at the start of Season 3. Then he played with Rux for
at
a little
point,
while.
At one point,
At one point. Then Edward, Zekant, and now St. Vicious.
Quite a lot. And he himself has changed play styles from really utility to going aggressive. Taking Draven under his wing is one of his most played as well, along with the Spring Split and a bit of the Last. No Cleavers to be thrown in the top lane. Sigh of relief for both top laners.
Shyvana could throw out an E, maybe.
Yeah, a little bit of fire.
Hasn't even skilled anything up. Doesn't want to get trapped. Interesting trend, by the way, that junglers aren't getting pulls anymore in LCS play. So much of the lanes have become about getting level 2 first. You can see these bottom lanes. Every game is a constant race to try and get those creeps down. Everyone wants to get their lane shoving. And if one set goes to the buff to pull, they lose that battle and immediately lose their advantage in the lane. So junglers have just taken to doing whatever they want. They just have to solo the buffs. And junglers that are being picked competitively are strong enough to not take a whole bunch of damage. But it is a new development for sure.
We just had some mirrored wards in the mid lane. They all just died, but the exact same wards were placed on either side of Coast and Curse. As that vision goes away, they know they're safe to go a little bit more aggressive in the lane. Shifter's trying to get that cleared out faster than Voidboy can really attack back. We see Quaz hitting level 2, tries to dish out a bit of damage.
Quaz winning the battle very early, as Renekton does. It's a tricky matchup for Nekton and Shyvana. With the Doran's Blade now, the itemization will tell you how they'll be playing. Kwas definitely looking to shove in, knowing he has the Pantheon jungle, who also has a stronger jungle presence than Vi early. It's not just about the matchup in the top lane. You also have to factor in the jungles. A lot of early ganks coming. Double buff rush.
Oh, right on the shifter. That's the one they need to shut down. That's the one they are going to shut down. And no retaliation can come on that.
Unexpected by shifter, because I Will Dominate did not do a small camp in between his double buffs. Therefore, Shifter thought he had about 15 more seconds before a potential Pantheon gank. Really good by I Will Dominate to get the jump on him, flashing in for the stun before Shifter could react.
Very good play. Shifter blows flash there, so he will not have that. Level 6 needs to come fast for him. It's going to be a dangerous mid lane. Buys up the ring to get himself a little bit more HP, keep himself safe.
And Gragas destroys people he gets ahead of. Shifter is going to have to be so cautious in that lane, knowing his flash is down and he's against a jungle Pantheon. Oh boy. Gragas gets even in body slam range, Shifter will take a heap of damage. And because the kill also went to Void Boy, Chalice of Harmony already completed, plus a pink ward to deward whatever side he sees Shifter go to.
Nintendo Dex came up a little bit late on that, but he was in the right spot. Shifter, unfortunately, blowing flash. Nintendo might have to spend some more time in mid than he would like. Dominate now looking to work off of that advantage. He's going to be going into the jungle and start denying Nintendo. Oh, no race to deny. Just a word for now.
Yeah, Nintendo cleared out just fine. He's just getting control of that area. Because he's the gank master early on in the game. He needs to know where Nintendo is for potential counter ganks. And the fact that he could get a deep ward there was a good opportunity to take.
Much more pressure coming out of Cop or with Fusion in this lane. Usually you see the Thresh lane trying to poke out the Caitlyn in the same way around, but with Saint Vicious hovering on that stun, they just keep it safe. Shifter forced to farm at the turret. Was it back there coming in? No, just Gragas. Void Boy going to farm other camps.
Dominate a little bit low on experience after that successful gank. He should be fine though, about to hit level 4. Calming down the game after that initial gank. So many flashes were burned by the junglers that the gank potency has actually been decreased. Means they're both in a bit of a farm phase right now, just trying to power up, get their next item.
Dominate going across the bottom ward just placed over here by Void Boy, but I think he will be seen. They won't be able to activate too much, but he is the one to make the plays. He is the mouth that is talking in the early part of the game as we've been talking about shot callers today. You can see he feels it's all right to put himself in those stressful situations. The team's doing all right.
Yeah, Dominate, because he saw the ward on the other side, knows it's safe to go in there. But as far as the general game goes, Shifter really needs to play from behind here because he is just so incredibly pivotal to all of Coast strategies. Throughout this season, Wiz Fusion has not been able to carry a single game for them. It's pretty much been Shifter and Zion Spartan. Fusion is good at playing the safe AD carry who can take turrets and stay alive in teamfights, but not when he's trying to carry. Here's that top line gank.
Ooh, we talked a little bit about gank potency here. The Vault Breaker doesn't hit, and the buffs have just worn off a little bit ago from Nintendo. So they get a good amount of damage and set Zion Spartan up to do something. The Shifter's going to have a hard time here with the pressure he's been getting.
Yeah, just a time-filling gank more than anything for Nintendo. He got a big boost of experience, actually, after Shifter died. So the Vi ganks at level 6 have the potential to impact the game sooner rather than later. If there were a time to try and come back, it would be that Vi gank in the mid lane.
Such a small window to play with, though, hopefully.
Because the Pantheon will be 6 shortly after and would wreck them in a counter gank. Nintendo has to be very careful.
Dominate won't be getting that 6 too soon as he goes again to get him right for here. The counter jungling. Goes for the ward. They have all the vision that they need, but they're not really working with any of it. They're just making sure they don't get aggressed on. Here, he tries to go for it, but just on the other side. A little cat and mouse game.
Yeah, Dominate. Second time he's counter-jungled the white. I think he wants to get blue buff control.
Treat it like the Wraiths.
Well.
The Wraiths are up. Get the
white. He's maintaining ward presence in that blue buff area as well. Just taking the white while he is up there. And he didn't know previously which camp Nintendo had started on, but since blue buff hasn't spawned and we're now 7:44 into the game, he knows that Nintendo is clearing his red right now. So he's just waiting for the blue buff, hoping it comes up soon.
The bottom knows about this. You're going to see possibly Comp and St. Vicious making some moves, and they do start to creep up ever so slowly. St. Vicious by himself here. It looks like they're going to get good control.
Any minute now, Dominate. It's going to come up. Any second. There it is. They had a decent estimation of the timer there. And good ward control, knowing that Ari had went back to the base as well. This is a clean buff steal, I think. Nintendo just a few seconds late. If they waited in the camp, they could kill him. Do not fall breaker in there. Bad.
What? That was not the greatest decision to be made. It's going to be Nintendo going down for the second kill of the game. Boy Boy picking up a red buff on that as well.
Definitely a lapse in awareness there by Nintendo. A lot of people were missing.
Yeah.
And the team needed to alert them. Is that the flash from Saint?
Ooh, Daydreaming trying to get himself out of this one. Saint with still having the stun up. They can kind of just put their dukes up in this fight. Saint throws Tibbers inside and not on really anything. Could they still come out with a win on this fight? Daydreaming not going to die there. Shifter goes across. He gets the kill onto Dominate. And that was a lot of damage missed. Daydreaming still alive. They come back and kill it. Whoa.
3-0 right there. A huge turn from Coast in just an instant by their team. And that's the worst part right now, because Curse can't communicate during a pause. There's a whole lot they want to say to each other right now after a disaster like that. Just really frustrated faces right there across the board from Curse. I'd love to know what just happened in that game.
Talking to QC right now.
We always have to hope that it wasn't a big team fight impacting bug. If it would deem to be as game changing or not, that is a referee call from the rule book. If it is a game breaking bug or not, we'll have to figure out what happened in that situation. A lot of sad faces there on Curse so far. If the fight was clean, we'll see what happened.
Gonna have to recheck that one. Right now, the team's just waiting. This game is getting quite intense here as we are into our last game of the day. The gold's only 200 apart. Both teams have been making hit-for-hit moves across the map.
Yeah, the game really just started. I think the very early gank by Owl Dominate was incredibly key, but in that moment, because Coast came back so strong and Shifter would have just been back in the game on Ari, it's kind of a fresh slate as far as who would win this game. Potentially a disaster there at the Dragon Pit by Curse.
Shifter was able to get some pretty good kills off of that after the fight came about, and he's been having a hard time. Kudos to Curse for the pressure onto him in the first gank and making sure they deny his buff as well. Because if Shifter can't get going, then Coast may not be able to get going.
Yeah, and in the context of the season, these are very important games for these guys too. These are the ones fighting around the bottom of that. The sixth place teams and above get to go to the playoffs. Seventh and eighth immediately get placed in the promotion tournament. Very, very key. Coast has been a part of a lot of promotion tournaments, you know?
They do find themselves kind of up and down in the standings. Yep. They crawl up at the end, but that's kind of scary, right? You want that to happen in the beginning. You want the momentum to be strong, especially now going 2-0 versus Curse. If you want to get a win on this team and figure out how to do it at the halfway point so you can at least stop it from being a 4-0 over the entire season.
Mm-hmm. It could be a nice turn for Curse. St. Fitch's is having some issues. We're going to... Obviously, when those get fixed, we would try to get back in the game. But as far as just the way this season has gone for Coast, it's been a pretty interesting one because they had a lot of hype coming into it. They had a very successful offseason, I'd have to say, in the NACL and various amateur leagues, really dominating. Huge, huge win percentages. But the play style that they had in most of those games was very much about roaming and taking over the mid game. They would play a very conservative style. And then Shifter would be able to roam on a variety of champions. He would do Katarina, Kassadin before it was banned every game, Ahri, LeBlanc, stuff like that. And they were dominating people. And as soon as they came into the LCS, they kept trying that strategy on everyone they played. But it's kind of a higher level of play in the LCS. And everyone was warding him out. His roams weren't working. And now they've slowly kind of evolved this new style of play where they are mainly avoiding teamfights unless the other team puts themselves in very bad positions. And so far, after that disastrous start to the season, it's beginning to work again. False start.
All right, yeah, Saint was dead there. He was coming back up. They're making sure his abilities could still work. And we're going to make sure that they do. It looks like it might be glitched out for a second here. We'll get that fixed. Both teams. Oh, actually, other side of the board. So we'll see what happens here. We're going to get a quick replay of the last fight that we did see. It was completely positioned off. Both teams were assessing the fight and then just kind of going for it was the first. It's the who makes the first move is kind of loses the fight idea.
Yeah, in that last fight, it was definitely Curse who made the first move. But Coast, they came out pretty strong, as we can see right here. Everyone getting trapped in the Baron Pit or Dragon Pit. We can see Shifter working all over the place. I'm trying to watch Saint. He was out of mana in most of this. Just auto attack.
So close. He's like, I just want the double buffs. Give me the double buffs, the last auto attack.
Well, it's kind of good he didn't get that kill because it would have given him double buffs back to Ahri.
Yeah.
He's the one who picked up the kill. It would have been buff transfer complete, as a lot of people like to say. Huge turnaround there. Very surprising because Curse had burned so much before that fight, killing Nintendo X on Vi, that when the dragon fight actually happened, they didn't have that much left, which I think was very critical.
Sion Spartan also down on the bottom side of the map for partially this engagement, but really there to help the team. That leaves that Kwas was in the top lane, so a little more aggression there coming in from Coast as they were prepared. You get a keyboard plugged back in here. Get these guys set and going. And see the quietness is kind of just cutting through the air, if you will, because these guys want to talk.
Unfortunately, we have a few issues coming through here. Actually, it's a keyboard problem for Shifter and the Saint Vicious problem. We're not sure if that's resolved yet because the keyboard problem surfaced before Saint had respawned to see if his issue had been resolved. So hopefully we don't have much. Shifter's saying, all right, looks like it's going. He's putting his headset back on. Maybe we can get back into this one.
All right, QC making the checks around. Our last game of the day here, game 64. 64 games into the LCS.
Nice.
It's gone quick.
It's a good number.
Even with some long games.
This has been such a great season, especially North America, I feel like. There's so many stories. Every team has an engaging chance. A lot of improvement across the board and just more defined styles for a lot of these teams.
Yep.
Coast in particular, TSM with Bjergsen, very mid lane dominating style. Balls has been amazing for Cloud9 in the top lane. You know, CLG's crazy resurgence right now. Again, going to be trying to make a run to be a top team in North America very shortly. I really can't wait to see how the rest of this split unfolds.
It's crazy to see that one person, I said this before, that one person has changed so many teams. Different positions, different roles. It's always been the one guy that brings it true. Coast going for the Dragon now.
Yeah.
9.5 minutes into this game. Looks like they're going to have a pretty good control on that. As Curse is back towards their base. Kwas, however, trying to get the top turret down as we're back in.
Yeah, Saint looks good. We have just received word. So, and Saint always looks good, but he's bug-free, which is the important thing.
Bug-free and calling the shots again for the team. He's picked himself up. Let's see. Sightstone with that going back. So the sweeper's out. It is going to be circling itself back up so he can use it. But for now, they're going to be walking around, just setting down the vision, trying to regain control of that bottom lane. Good job by Cop being good at 10, 12 CS up.
Hello. Is Kwas strong enough right now to take that side? It does not seem like he would be.
He hasn't really finished an item.
Yeah.
He's going for the pieces of everything.
Yeah, he wants to finish off his Tiamat. Yeah, pushing as quickly as possible, but he was a level behind there a second ago, so more farming incoming in that top lane.
3-2 here as we're back into this one. Like we said, the gold lead very close. Even with that dragon going down just now, it's still about 300 gold that only that Coast has in their favor. Daydreaming, still sitting with that double buff in the bottom lane. They're not really going to be using that to any sort of aggression, but the mid lane aggro, can Boy Boy get in range for the cast? He cannot. Dominate goes for the man drop.
A lot burned there for, I believe, just a charge of the ultimate from Shifter. That was very brute force, trying to take advantage of Void Boy's big item edge on Shifter. He was 600 gold ahead of him prior to that gank as well. Athene's Unholy Grail completed on Void. But they just couldn't combo anything together. Now a lot of threat from the jungle is down. Every lane, and especially Nintendo Dex, does not have to fear the Pantheon counter gank anymore.
I also see Dominate coming out of the jungle, a little bit behind in CS, and a completed item as well. Nintendo may feel comfortable about going for that engagement in the bottom lane. Shifter has to be very careful about what gets himself into up here.
Yeah, he knows what just walked in his jungle. That means Nintendo can go!
St. Vicious gets locked up, hooked up, played backwards. They don't even have to put the box out, but they still order one for him. 4-2 now, Coast.
Big moves. It seems like the momentum is completely back. With Curse, Dominate.
Using the Aegis to get out. Very nice. Quick little moves, keeps Dominate safe with a little bit of help of Void Boy there. You always got to know that your jungler or your mid laner, your top is behind you when you're going for that gank. Or the invade, Kwas getting hit up here in the top lane. Both top laners 9 in their levels, so not too much of a 1v1 fight to be had there.
I really do wonder what happened in that dragon fight between Curse to go with our extended pause.
Yeah.
Obviously, there's been a lot of replay analysis is going to happen after the fact, but it does seem like it's very negatively affected Curse. Just the extended pause and the disaster of that fight. Ever since we've gotten out of the pause, Dominate's been playing very forced. They don't seem to be communicating that well, and there's a chance Coast could take complete control of this game.
Well, slowly still trying to put pressure on Shifter in the mid lane. That's the way that Coast is going to get it. Void Boy, with a good hit right there. Didn't think that Shifter's ultimate might be up just yet from the last engagement, but it is, and they stay safe on the trade.
Yeah, Shifter still, though, taking a lot of damage. Void Boy still has a big edge in that lane. You know, he's got the only kills on Curse. He has the big CS advantage. He's really been taking that first blood and trying to dominate Shifter with it. This will be kind of the first time if Coast is to win. Or not the first time. But even though they're a solo lane focused team, it's just Zion. He's on a Shyvana. You don't necessarily think of them as solo killing. Wiz Fusion's going to probably have to step up, looking at how far behind Shifter is falling.
Wiz Fusion, 2-0-1. We've seen him come from very far behind in the game, but we've also seen him use a huge lead and not really go anywhere with it. It'll be interesting to see how he uses this one. He's not really going to be able to get out of that lane with the team just yet. We still have some laning phase to go through. 700 gold, the favor for Coast is that slowly keeps going up in their favor.
Yeah, Coast definitely just trying to take that gold advantage and boost it farther and farther ahead.
Oh, Dominate.
He really wants to get a Pantheon ultimate off, but, you know, especially with no turret behind them. He's going hard right now. Ooh. All flashes are up.
He just finished that Lizard, Elder. He wants the damage. They get the surge, but do they finish it? The Ace of the Hole!
No!
The Wiz Fusion flash was a bit too far.
Whoops. That was bad flash right there. A strange series of events there. Normally it's the AD carry who needs to play in front and the Thresh Lantern that saves him, but the AD carry went back and Thresh stayed in the middle. A very successful gank by Curse. Was supposed to probably just burn both flashes with Wiz Fusion blocking, but the misplay cost Daydream his life.
Tiamat finished in the top lane. So we got the Ninja Tabis as well. Zion Spartan looking to take out Kwas, but Kwas is looking to push back just as hard. See if Zion can keep himself up there. No teleport in this game, so whatever happens in the top lane should too much affect what happens down here, and in 1 minute, we have a dragon.
Yeah, the dragon fight's going to be incredibly important here, Riven. Just to give an update on the long pause, it's still being investigated what happened to St. Pitches, if it was a bug. Obviously, we will keep you updated on what happens here, but it's the game at hand, and these guys have to play like everything is on the table, like everything matters, because it does.
Yep, 133 CS to 114 in the top lane, 128 to 79 in that mid lane. Void Boy faring a lot better than Bjergsen did in this matchup.
Oh yeah, Void Boy, just off that level 2 kill from Owl Dominate, is crushing, and it's going to be so key as we move into this dragon fight, whether he can land the right skill shots. This is a point in the game where Gragas can either take over or start falling off, knowing he has Sorcerer Shoes from Magic Penetration, fully completed the Thanes, ultimate up, ignite up.
Yeah.
If he can land stuff in this dragon fight, if it happens, it can swing the game right back for Curse.
And this is huge, too. He is level 11 with that second ultimate tick. Shifter's still level 10, so he's coming in with a level 1. Oh, Coast is going for this. Really, Curse is not going to try and divide. Wow.
Yeah. Timing for Curse.
Yeah.
One of the weaknesses of their team has been their overall map movement and being in position for objectives. That was a moment where they would have had to try and take an edge. Annie at that point, just as you said, 2 points in the explosive cask for Gragas.
Yeah.
Is the time for him to get aggressive and a real missed opportunity here for Curse.
Shifter back to farming in the mid lane. He's still got about a 50 CS deficit, but his blue buff is there and Shifter can still make plays. We've seen him do it. He's so close to having the Deathfire grasp and very close. He's on top
there
of
it. Is.
It's in his pocket.
No magic penetration yet. I don't think he can really burst out Gragas with it. If he wants to do something, he'd have to go for a squishy AD carry or a support like Copper St. Vicious. And with the blue buff on Void Boy, Shifter's not going to be getting any roaming opportunities. At best right now, Shifter needs to wait for a Vi gank or just try and keep his turret alive.
Right now, he's been doing quite well. The flash is back up for him. He's been using his ultimate to get out of scary spots, and Dominate looks to create one of those again.
They could consider a dive here, knowing there's no flashes. As long as they don't run into Nintendo Dex, that's the fear. They have pretty poor ward coverage. knowing where Nintendo to be, and if they could have went about 10 seconds ago, but if they go now, they actually run the risk of getting by countergamed.
Looks like he'll back off for now. If Ping comes in the mid lane and they say we might try to go after mid, no. Void Boy still has eyes on it. Can't really tell what that ping means.
Here it goes, but Vi's right there.
Daydreamin's going to be in a bad spot, but they are going to hit up Dominate. He tries to get the Aegis in from the backside. Wiz looking to get himself a kill. They do finish off the one Retribution kill coming in for Daydreamin. Ooh. Can they finish out in a cop? Nintendo's just on the outside. Turn around and take down Saint. The stun's coming in. He's going to go down valiantly, trying to do the max amount of damage. Ooh, good trap.
Oh, and he's trying to spear rush. He just needs to get in range.
Whoa, the spirit flash. Oh.
The fourth dash is the one that kills him from Ahri. But that was a very risky call by Curse that backfired. As soon as Vi is there, whoever shows themselves first in these 3v3 scenarios generally loses. It means Pantheon gets put in a very difficult position where he has to run away most of the time, and then Coast can just fully aggress onto Cop. They ended up getting split up in here. Just a nice turn by Coast, knowing that Shifter was going to come from the backside to finish up Cop. And they clean house with some nice patience and good prediction by Nintendo Dex.
It looks like that fight went a little longer than Coast wanted. They didn't get caught out there. You saw Void Boy roaming down to the bottom lane. Everybody was straggling on that, but they get it cleaned up. We're now 18 and a half minutes in. 7 kills for Coast to the 4 of Curse as they grab about a 3,000 gold lead. 2 turrets in their favor. Definitely a slower turret game than we've seen today. More kills.
Yeah, everything really turned in that dragon fight where everyone on Coast got some kills. It allowed Shift to get back in the game. I think it really affected the mentality of Curse. They looked beaten after that dragon fight during the pause, and they have not recovered. They haven't really made any big positive plays. They've been forcing incredibly hard since that moment, almost just trying to make up for it. They're on tilt.
Oh, really interesting move. Wiz Fusion and Daydreamin go to the top lane to start pressuring the turrets as they send Sion Spartan to the bottom lane now.
Yeah, and the push is just big from Coast. They did the lane swap, and they're getting a lot of turret damage down. Outer turret for inner turret would not be a good trade. Let's see if Fusion can get this turret down. He does a lot of split pushing, actually, for Coast.
Using the culling to help himself get a little more breathing room on that turret in the top lane. Whoa. For the bottom lane. Initiation out of the brush. Sion Spartan goes huge, and they're going to go back onto Cop. He has no chance to get out of this fight. Beautiful job not allowing Curse to even peel for 1 second. Zion is still on the tails of St. Vicious, and he goes down 2-0 so far. And they got that top turret as well in the second tier.
It's really important to note that that was a 3v4 that Coast decided to go into, but their initiation was so clean that they completely decimated the Curse team because there were two people that had just killed the turret in the other lane. No one on Curse expected that counterattack. So Coast really pulling the trigger at the right moment there. Huge surprise.
A good move by Curse. They're kind of cleaning up a mess right now, though. They're only able to do this because Coast is so deep on the side lanes that they were pushing in that they can grab mid, but better than nothing right here for Curse. They're down still 4,000 gold. They have grabbed turrets back in their favor, so they're starting to get a little map control back. But right now with the gold, Shifter ready to get that Deathfire grasp out, and the vision up for Coast is going to help them start getting picks.
Yeah, and as Coast continues to try and rescue their season, everyone's going to have to step up. This is kind of the game for Wiz Fusion at this moment. He is the richest member on Coast by far. 8,700 gold. He's actually 1,700 more gold than anyone else on Curse right now. 402 on Lucian. In the past, when he's gotten a few early kills, he has had poor positioning in teamfights and really made all that gold go to waste. Lucian is a very elusive champion at this point. Their team is ahead, and he's going to have to be the one to continue to make that gold have an impact.
You see, he is, like you said, quite ahead in gold, and that shows with the Bloodthirster Phantom Dancer and just a pickaxe after the Bloodthirster on the side of Cop. We saw Cop just get dove right now, and they're looking to gain back map control. 4 pink wards in the inventory of Curse right now. One's on the map. I think that's going to be Quas's in the top lane, so you can't even put another one down right now.
Yeah, you can definitely see. Big dragon fight could be up here. But Curse has just been slow on these. At this point, with no vision control, it would be suicide to try and walk through that point because they'd get hit by an Ahri charm or even a hook. They're
going in! There's the hook. calling over the wall, but who can follow this? Coast, you're getting a little crazy on this one. Curse is going to try to reassess the fight, but they're still taking a ton of damage. Wiz Fusion does get himself over the wall, does get himself a double kill, and it's going to be Daydreaming to clean up the last one on the Saint.
You expect the fight when the team walks into the river. You do not expect the fight to happen over top of the back of the Dragon Wall. And Coast gets four kills, another surprise fight, catching Curse off guard. Four kills the Dragon and the push mid.
Wiz is putting on the stutter step before they take down the mid turret. Great siege clear as well when they get to these waves. The Ahri Orb of Deception and the rest of the call, or the rest of the queue coming in from Wiz Fusion on Lucian. And they easily take down mid turret. Really great play from Coast.
Yeah, this seemed like a crazy initiation, yeah. But they get Kopp down very early on. They just get so much damage on them that he's kind of out of the fight. Zion Spartan is just an unstoppable force. And remember, we talked about Fusion getting his position right. Mm-hmm. That was just him following up on the really strong tank line. Historically this season, when Coast has ran Zion and Tendude on dive buddies, it hasn't worked. They haven't been able to coordinate their initiation to go in together. That time, the Assault and Battery plus the Dragon's Descent just worked right. And you saw how well it can work when they look strong.
Very good engages indeed. Zion Spartan's second engage like that to come out. We just saw in what's called the Fnatic Brush in the bottom lane. They got a good fight and a kill on the Kopp there. And now working their advantage. Small power plays here, really putting him in the lead. Zion's big, but he has Dragon's Descent up. The ult for just a few abilities. Curse is liking the position they're getting here. They got to continue to work it like that.
Trying to give Coast a taste of their own medicine. Mm-hmm. This game, Coast has done a lot of brush baiting already, especially with DFG Ahri. Ahri would be able to kill whoever comes in the way. Gotta say, Curse is in a pretty dangerous spot right here. They're trying to force team fights like they normally excel, but it may be too late. They've given up 13 kills already to the side of Coast, and if that last fight is any indication, they lose those fights pretty bad.
Coast wards. Ready for the extended fight. They kind of just string down into that mid lane of Curse. They really wouldn't have an escape right now. You see that Coast knows where they are, so they can push this safely, get themselves and their lanes pushed up in a good position for this Baron attempt slash force that they might try.
All that vision that Curse had just worked to accomplish is gone. Both pink wards finished. Lane's getting pushed out by Coast. And yeah, we had a tweet come in just a second ago there on the ticker about how Coast, even though they look strong, they need to know how to finish.
Yep.
The previous two games they've lost to Curse, they've actually had leads that they've lost at the Baron Pit. So they are going to be proceeding with a lot of caution, I think, around here. But if they have strong vision control, I would almost expect Coast to peel for a fight rather than deal with another potential smite steal from Isle Dominate. Pantheon could come in at any moment and steal if Coast decided to do that Baron. So they're really just driving them off.
Yeah.
Right now.
Setting up around that Wraith area, it looks like they're really liking this gap-closing initiation. Coming over the wall, trying to surprise the team, really get the stampede in there just from gap-closing. You don't really have anybody to run with you. Just get in right away. 13-5, 25 minutes into the game, still sweeping out the Baron Pit. They're just using them, like we said, the sweepers of their feet right now. If they're not up, they're not moving.
Waiting in the spot, they get a ping right on top of them. They're saying, they're probably here. How do you check?
Oh.
How do you check that? You want to get in a war
You get
position.
A scrying orb.
Then he might die.
Dominate is going to be the one, but the whole team is just to the right of them. The Dragon's Descent hits Kopp and Void Boy. That is Kopp trying to caliber net out of the fight, and his knight is on him as well. St. Vicious is going to get bit down by the Dragon. A good hit up by Void Boy. Stop Zion Spartan there for a second. Quash is going to go down, but no. Void Boy gets a kill before that happens.
Ooh.
He flashes out with the barrel over the shoulder. Gets a double kill for himself nicely. That was also a shutdown onto Wiz Fusion, which is a six-kill shutdown, but he still gets taken down in the end.
Even with the kill from Nintendude, Void Boy kept Curse alive in this game with those fancy moves right at the end of that fight. And speaking of scrying orbs, it would have been nice here because all of this happened because they were trying to get vision of that brush. The team fight erupts, and it's actually not that bad positioning from Curse. Coast didn't have the cleanest initiation onto Curse, and that's why they're kind of safe. Void Boy and Kopp, you can see on the back lines, are still dishing out a lot of damage. And then when Void Boy re-engaged for this fight, I thought for sure he was dead. But the dash away, as he threw out the barrel, really caught Fusion off guard. That's that team fight position he has to be careful of, going glass cannon on Lucian, walking right face first into a Gragas barrel.
8,000 gold lead, still for Coast here.
Yes, sir.
not looking too good for Curse, but they are getting a few fights that's putting money in their pocket. Rabadons, Athenes, and the Sork Boots now up for Void Boy as he tries to finish out that Void Staff, which is going to give him a lot of explosive power. And we saw what he just did to Wiz Fusion, who still isn't putting any defense in there. Feeling comfortable, 6-1-6, finished up his last Whisper.
Yeah, knowing how Lucian is so elusive, it isn't a champion you need to build defensive items on necessarily. Void Boy, though, showing the ability to reach him with a couple of the spells. If the tank line protects Coast and Fusion plays in the right spot, he should be able to continue to build damage. And I think we're going to see a Reaper performance in the last fight. It's all about the vision control and the potential engagements. Nintendo Deck's very willing to fly in, knowing they have this big lead. Shock calling right now, since they're ahead, is just kind of, all right, move as a group and just bully the other team around the map.
Right.
Because even just by the team composition, Coast is stronger team fighting, not even mentioning their 8,000 gold.
Stronger team fighting indeed. We also mentioned at the beginning of this game that Curse loves those team fights. And even down in gold, we saw him fare pretty well as
Curse
the Baron
was
started.
Going down towards the Dragon. They got spotted by War. Coast immediately went on Baron. And even though there's been some steals in the past, Curse would have to get a miracle to get down here. This Baron is Coast.
As soon as those abilities come up, you can just see the health being shredded.
Now they're going to wait.
Are they going to wait?
Oh, cancel the ult.
No! Dominate. It's Dominate.
Right in the middle of five very angry men right there. Now they got no jungler. They're on the run.
No. They, ooh. Oh. Yeah, he sees him. He's not going to let him back. This is going to be great. He'll say, no, they are not backing. Do as much damage to that turret as you want. They're only going to have Annie back now.
There's only two people back in the base right now, and that is not enough to start four. They also have a lot of initiation potential. Nintendo might just try and ult the first guy he sees.
They're still running Void Boy into the bottom lane as well, so this inhibitor is going to go down after the Baron. Quite seamless here for Coast in the last few moves.
Yeah, as soon as Coast got an inch in this game, they've taken a mile. Six turrets and an inhibitor, plus every objective they can get their hands on. Dragon's still up. They're going to take that whenever they want. Zion is also a dragon. That helps.
That helps a lot. Dragon versus a dragon. You got to bring some of it so you can take it down. 17-8, coming up on 30 minutes in the game, and Coast has already opened up the base of Curse in this game. 11,000 gold lead coming in. They're sitting pretty on a lot of core items, and they're synergizing the Randuins together as well, not letting Curse out of these fights once they're started.
Not in the slightest. Really strong performance by Coast after the rough start to the game. Mm-hmm. Big gold totals coming out all across. You can see Wiz Fusion still, though, 12,700. 616 top kills on his team. Good performance for him on Lucian.
And it really didn't come from the lanes. You can still see that most and all the lanes are below. 232 for Quas, 215 for Zion. Same thing in the AD, same thing in the mid. This wasn't the lane game for Coast. They did a great job as they broke out of that.
A lot of team fighting and properly forced fights. Even just some 3v4s when they knew they had the edge because they could get the jump on Curse. Really giving them a taste of their own medicine, you know? A team with Pantheon Gragas is normally the team that tries to catch people out.
Yep.
But Coast, because they're so used to playing that style, are just doing it with the teamfight competition.
And it's really good to see Coast doing this as well without Shifter 11-0 and 100. Without Zion Spartan crushing down the top lane, everybody's contributing here. Mainly Wiz Fusion. A lot of people have had eyes on him. Not been performing in the bottom lane with Daydreamin'. This time they're bringing it around.
It is very important for a team's future that their star player can have a bad game or just an average game, and the team still have a successful
good point.
One. That hasn't happened for Coast yet this season. This could be game one of it.
Good bit of damage onto the turret. Zion Spartan very tanky, and he can put himself in quite a dangerous position under that turret. As they get the traps out, he goes to the other side, and he's going to start creating chaos here. Curse has to spread thin to stop this.
Down Spartan going to be able to regen up all that stuff right there, because the Baron buff gives a huge amount of health regeneration based on your maximum health. Slowly ticking down these two turrets as well. These turrets all though regen, so if Coast doesn't stick around for too long, all the little damage they're getting on these turrets will go to waste. They got to be able to finish one of them.
We just got an ace in the hole. I think that went back to Wiz Fusion as they may look to drop the turret on this one. Triforce isn't there for Wiz, so you're not going to see that Lucian huge damage coming out on the turret.
Yeah. But they got a Nexus turret thanks to their double push on the middle and bottom lane. There's no one able to go back to defend that Nexus turret, and they get that one. Here's the last ditch initiation.
That's going to be going for Broke. Dominates into the fight. He gets charmed right off the bat, and they take him down. Zion Spartan's trying to focus. A great cask onto three, and it's a shutdown onto Nintendude. Zion in the middle of the fight now as they turn the calling around. Cops getting hit with just about every bullet, and even with slivers of health, Coast continues on to the base.
They're still low. Void Boy is still very healthy. How well can he defend this inhibitor? It's a very dangerous game. One charm, he's down.
His ultimate is not up. He's got a double kill coming in. Can't turn around. Cobb's here, but he takes a huge shot to the face. Wind Fusion gets taken out. Quad's trying to come in big here. A slice and a dice would cut up Zion Spartan, but they try to save the base.
Void Boy really just keeping Curse in this game. He could have died. The game would have been over. But he went for it and he got a double kill. The rest of the team backed him up. They still lost pretty much their entire base, though, and desperately have to fight this one off.
Whoa, Dragon Scales being enough to keep Zion Spartan alive. Level 16 as well to the level 15 to cop, so that'll always help a little bit.
Take a look at this movie. Dodges the charm and then just wrecks them with that barrel. Of course, Fusion as well, still pretty strong, but cop gets just enough damage down. Notice how he used his E and his Q while he was jumping away. If you use your Piltover Peacemaker while you're netting away, you get both the casts off. And the Piltover Peacemaker uses the range from when you initially cast it,
right,
not from where your eventual location is. So it has really good reach. That's one of the reasons they were able to finish off Wiz Fusion.
Quick fingers equals good damage. We got 8-2-7 onto Wiz. He's still doing well for himself. Goes for the Infinity Edge as well. And we can see Ko starting to pick up some red elixirs here. I'm sure Curse is going to be doing the same thing as it's getting to that point in the game.
Yeah, with Baron being back up in a minute and 40 seconds, it seems like Curse would have to concede it. Although, they have three inhibitors up, so they don't have to worry about super minions pushing. It's just the overall vision control has been so poor. They haven't been out in that area since the last Baron went down. And as soon as one person on Curse gets picked off, the game would be over because there's no turrets up.
Yeah.
Curse's base, they have one Nexus turret and one inhibitor defending turret in the mid lane. So I believe like Coast is just going to put up a bit of a front here in the bottom lane, not looking to get anything necessarily. Wait for the Baron to come up and then go there. They're probably going to throw some charms out randomly. If they get a charm, they could just go and win the game. If they don't, they're going to back away.
This is going to be absolutely crazy if Curse can win a fight. There are so many things weighing against them right now. Even in the just on Daydreaming,
yeah,
the Talisman and Aegis to help the team. The Mikhail's coming up again. Things Curse cannot work with in these fights.
Yeah, but Coast is playing really aggressively right now. They're incredibly confident. If they were to lose a fight here, they would also lose the Baron. So a bit of a dangerous posture there by Coast.
Coast possibly looking for this mid lane. Get a push. Take down the last turret. Don't do anything out of the ordinary, and it looks like that's what they will get done. Good choice here. Calls being made by Zion Spartan, possibly. They still said that it goes through everyone in the team, but whoever's the loudest at that time and the most confident, they'll go with it.
Not the suggested way of shot calling. Whoever's the loudest. CLG tried that for a few years.
Yep.
Didn't work out for them very well. At this point, though, it's the vision control in the Baron buff area. Curse showing themselves, trying to counter push mid lane. We might see an initiation here from Coast. They're all there. They killed the ward.
Ooh.
Where's the scrying orbs, guys? Start scouting Baron with it. They're pushing mid instead.
Still only one sweeper.
A pretty good call,
Curse,
actually, by Curse. They're going to get at least a turret out of this while Coast takes Baron. See how much they can get.
A very scary Coast. It's going to be pretty big.
They should kind of run away right now. At this point, Coast has the chance to flank them from two sides. They have the tank line coming in from behind to cut them off, and the damage coming up with home guard boots. Curse has to run very quickly.
And now Curse actually can't get back to their base without this fight being forced. A good trap, but it's going to be the Banshee's Veil that eats that up. See if they can keep it. Zion Spartan is going to stop him from backing. Everybody's coming in from the backside. Nintendude X still with his Randuin's up, letting this Randuin's fall off. Then he's going to put his onto the fight. Dominate very low.
Oh.
He could have Dragon Descent in time.
He's free.
He gets out and looks like the rest of the team is going to be safe as well.
Woo. And they get two turrets out of it. So they were going to lose the Baron anyway. They end up saving themselves with a couple of turrets. That'll be good gold if they can get back and buy it. But this is still a very dangerous situation for them because it is a Baron buff, huge amount of gold on Coast, and the second big chance for them to win the game. An extended siege about to happen at Curse's Inhibitors.
Five dragons, two barons in the game. Everything has been taken by Coast. The gold lead of 14,000 shows it. 9-5 in turrets. two more stand on the map, and it's not two Nexus turrets. One of those have already fallen. Coast is wreaking havoc on Curse's base right now.
Yeah, they're going to continue to rotate around here. Maybe set up a bit of a split push with Zion on one side and the rest of the team trying to siege down the turret like the way they were sieging last time. They're also very comfortable playing in that way. Zion loves being on his own as far as the team goes.
Oh, here comes...
They're grouped as five because they're so strong right now.
The definitive ability of Coast. Is it something that they have? They're going to try to pressure Curse into a bad situation here, but they also have to watch how far they get themselves in. 5v5, if anything were to happen right now, it looks like they could be forced to give this
Curse
up.
Curse is going to want to go pretty soon. If they lose two inhibitors, the third one is nearly indefensible, and at that point, once you lose three, the game is almost over. So it's kind of a breaking point right here if the second one goes down.
Doesn't look like it's going to be able to take too much more. There are traps there, but they can only do so much. Coast doesn't even want to dive through. They're able to get what they want from a distance, and now it's middle inhibitor turret for them.
Just a really hard situation to be in because Coast was playing safely enough that if Curse were to initiate, the game would be over. But because they got the second inhibitor down, the percentages dropped greatly for Curse to win the game. They're just getting the time now for the side waves to push with super minions in it while they push down this third middle turret. That's why Nintendo is way back trying to get that third one going down.
And the advantages of being so far ahead, like we talked about Mikhail's Crucible and Daydreaming, that Zephyr had to be picked up by Cobb himself. St. Vicious isn't going to be helping him with any of that utility support. So right now, he is spending money on things to keep himself alive instead of damage to fight back.
Very quick, Caitlyn.
Well, it's a little bit damage as well.
Speed. Last ditch initiation has to happen now.
There's a big Grand Skyfall. It's going to be in. Dominate goes down instantly in these fights. Zion Spartan, level 18, and probably the only one in the game as he waltzes around this fight. Whoop. Just picking a different partner to dance with this time. Great gab by Daydreaming. Cop's going to be on the backside. Level 18, Zion Spartan ain't doing too much for, or ain't doing enough for the team. He could do some more. Going in for more kills, and it's going to be a three kill for nothing here. Zion, real big in this fight.
That was the fight for Coast. They finally got the hook onto Boy Boy. Ended his reign of terror. This is the game.
There's a surrender coming in. The Nexus won't even be able to take down. They were going for Cop. Very clean on that one. Coast is loving this win streak.
Yeah, they've been looking better and better. A 2-0 week again for them. So upswing in the end of Coast season. Definitely that game. A more across-the-board performance. There was 9-2-9 was the score on WizFusion. The new AD carry for them this season, who has not seen too much immediate success. Shifter started this game pretty far behind Voivod. He ended with a good score, but it was because the team carried him this time. He wasn't carrying himself.
Zion Spartan doing so well on Shyvana. Couldn't even formulate a sentence at the end of the game about it. It was doing so well. Just such great play coming in from the top lane. Give him any champion now. It seems like he just needed a little bit of the season to find his own footing again.
Yeah.
Top lane was an island again this game. Zion took it home. He did a great job against Quas. Shifter was aggressed on very early in that part of the game. And then they took his blue. They tried to do more, but he still came back.
Confidence is key a lot for Zion Spartan. And he probably feels really good about that game too. Most of the games that he's won with Coast, he's done almost everything. You know, 1v1 kills with Lee Sin, crazy split pushing on Jax. This game, you know, a 1-1-14 Shyvana. He's happy that he was able to get a win after that.
WizFusion really bringing out all the stops on this game. Never has an AD carry game like that. We've seen him come from behind and go even. We've seen him have two kills in the early game.